I'm teaching in here.
Go.
I feel so close to you right now. It's a false feel. I wear my heart upon my sleeve like a big deal. Your love pours down on me, surrounds me like a waterfall. There's no stopping us right now. I feel so close.
Not you again.
To you.
Look, I've said to you before, will you learn to use manners when you ring on that stupid phone? I'm sick and tired of you doing the same thing all the time. You never learn. I'm also flat out in here, busy working for you, and here you come, you pester me and annoy me. Don't interrupt me. Go away. Go away and keep going. Go.
There's no stopping us right now. Feel so close to you right now. There's no stopping us right now.
Would you rather fight 1,000 duck-sized horses or one horse-sized duck?
Excellent question, Paige. Fantastic question. I suppose it depends on your definition of fight. In my definition, it's probably preserve yourself. Therefore, I reckon I could probably run away from one horse-sized duck.
I'd rather fight one horse-sized duck because you only got to get one blow in the right spot to bring it down.
Don't forget, you can lure a horse to water, but you can't make a duck drink. So, in saying that, I would like to take on the big duck behind the horse.
You don't get to see a horse-sized duck very often.
Do you often see duck-sized horses?
Yes.
I think I'd rather do the 100 duck-sized horses.
And why?
Because you could probably just kick them with your feet.
A duck-sized horse? What?
Why?
That was a big That's not good.
A big duck? Or 100 horses that size?
100 horses that size.
Why?
Because you can step on
them. Get in trouble in ancient a lot.
Oh, it's mainly me, but yeah.
You
I get
serious?
In trouble.
You get in trouble.
Yeah, I do.
He always finds it. Why do you, we went through this. Like,
I got a level 2. I got a level 2.
Are you serious? That wasn't me, that was me. Stop trying to take all my credit.
I did it.
Are you serious?
Where is your favourite place to swim and why?
I have to say that's Como Wharf.
Yeah, definitely Como Wharf. Good times I've had.
Yeah, it's a really big open swimming bay, and there's a lot of room for, you know, whatever you want to do there, you know?
Whatever you
basically
want.
Basically anything.
Oh, hey! Yeah, your relationship with Rosie.
I just want to make it clear to everyone that I have, in fact, been to Egypt.
So, YouTube, this is my message.
What is your favourite history? Why?
I hate you.
My favourite moment was when, in year 10, I farted during Peter's speech. It was really loud, and it kind of ruined her whole speech for her. I don't think she went very well. Sorry, Rena.
Oh, sorry. Just doing some light reading. Just my favourite Russian novel by Will and Brady, Russia and the Soviet Union. Wonderful read.
Hold me around.
I remember marvelling at two Year 7 boys called Sean and Scott, who seemed to know everything about computing. I remember watching Lauren Miletich beating the Endeavour boys almost single-handed at cricket after they didn't want to play against a team with a girl. I also remember taking these little Year 8 girls to Korea for the World Scholars Cup and getting great shopping tips from Lana Pintano. She's a great shopper. I remember in Year 8 threatening Liam McDonald at the end of the Zeus News that if he opened his mouth one more time, I would push him off the ferry, and everyone cheered.
Yo, Year 12. Sorry. Best of luck, Year 12. I hope you achieve every success that you deserve. Oh, you'll be missed. See you later.
We'll miss you. Love you. Bye. Yeah, I'll miss you so much. I love you guys. You love me too. Bye.
No comment.
Year 12, I'll be sorry to see you go because you have been a lot of fun. I so much liked my Year 10 class when you were in it. We had so much fun together. And my Year 12s have been great as well. So good luck in the future.
Hi, Year 12. I've had a really great 6 years with you. You've made all the memories really special and amazing. So, best of luck for the future.
My Year 12 class, what can I say? I have to put up with people like Jessica, put up with people like Agnes and Olivia and Ben and Jack. All of them, I just can't get them all out, especially Darwin. Oh my God, for 6 years Darwin has been something special at this school. But I wish them all the best. I love them and I'm going to miss them. Good luck, Year 12.
Year 12, farewell. Good to see you leaving. As I said to you before, I think sometimes kids get too old for school, and I think you've got a bit too old now. I think you're going to enjoy your future. And goodbye. Thanks for having a lot of laughs with me, and thanks for interacting with us in the class. See you around.
Alright, see you guys. It's been great getting to meet you. Next year I'm going to the Army, so I'll probably see many of you ever again. It's been really great, and I wish you all the best.
Hi, Year 12. I would want to wish you good luck in the future, in your HSC and next year in your future studies. But I would like to thank you for everything that you've done for our school over the past 6 years for many of you. You've been leaders in many different aspects of education, and we will miss you. We really appreciate what you've done. Thank you.
Bye, guys!
I feel like I'm in an episode of Star Wars, Paige. Now, Year 12, Mr. Littlejohn tells me that he's the best year advisor of all time, so yes, Brendan Drury, that means you must be the best Year 12 of all time. Adds up. All the best to all of you. I've taught a number of you over the years and really enjoyed it, and I hope that you stay studious leading up to the exams, and all the very best for those exams and for your future.
Year 12, what a year. And let's hope the next one's as good as the last.
Hey everyone, we're at the end now. It's been a really good ride. I know that I've done some dumb stuff and given myself a great name among the teachers, but I know that everyone at this school has become one, and it's been great, and I'm going to miss every single one of you.
Goodbye, Year 12!
I want to wish you all the very best for your future, and to remind you that you are not the sum total of your HSC marks, your ATAR. You are much finer people than that, and it says nothing about your character and how hard you've worked and how well you work together and the sorts of adults that you are going to be.
Hey guys, it's been a great 6 years, and for those that I've met after that, we've had a really good time, and I'll love all the times we've spent together, and I'll miss you. Best of luck in the future. Bye!
We really miss you, wish you the best, and we're going to miss you a lot, and we're not going to miss giving you late notes.
Hi, I'm Yem Dog. I've made some wonderful friends, and I've met some amazing students, and I really am going to miss you. So all the best, and I hope all your dreams come true. Bye.
Hey, Year 12. I can't believe how fast the last 6 years have gone, the last 2 years. I've gone really fast as well. It's been great getting to know you all. You're all great people. It's been really interesting to go and meet a great group of people who are really interesting and really different. And I'm going to miss you all a lot. I really love being your captains this year. And good luck for the future.
We'll miss you!
Hi, Year 12. I guess this is your goodbye.
had a fun 4 years with the laptops, and hope you go well with your endeavours or uni or TAFE or wherever you go. And just so you know, I'll be here if you need to come back. So I'll see you later.
Hi 12, it's been great being at Caringbah with you for the last, 6 years now. It's been great working with you all, getting to know you. Best of luck for the future and goodbye.
All the best for your future. I hope it proves to be everything you wish. And I blame your school captain for this silly outfit. Cheers, everyone.
Oh, one's apologising again. On a serious note, I'm just looking up a great word to use, and I'm looking up farewell. Interjection, goodbye. A function to mark a person leaving a job or district, and in this way, a school. I've been the luckiest teacher at Caringbah High for the last 6 years, being year advisor to a great bunch of students. Very independent. I'll admit I haven't been the best year advisor going around, but in saying that, I've loved every minute of it. The help from all the students along the way, how everyone in our year got along, had all different types of personalities, interests, but everyone worked well as part of the community in our year. It's a sad moment. A few students have asked me, am I going to miss? And I certainly will, just walking through the playground, always someone to chat to in our grade. It's just been a lot of fun on my behalf, a lot to change in my life over the last 6 years. And to see not only my own children be born and grow, but to see all of you, all of our Year 12 grow from Year 7 all the way through to Year 12. I cannot believe how fast it's been. It's just been the most rewarding part of my teaching life, and I'll never forget any of it. And one thing I will say, and I'll talk about it more on graduation night, is that life is never going to be handed to you on a silver platter. You're going to get knocked down, you're going to get knocked back into things, but you always must remember, stand up, get up, and never give up. I love you all.
Time to celebrate. It's our graduation day, yeah. So I'm not gonna cry.
I'm not gonna cry.
No, no, not a one sad or happy tear.
Not a one sad or happy tear.
I've waited my whole life. Now I'm gonna fly. This has been the best day of my life, so I'm not gonna cry. It's a bitter
sweet cry.
Not you again. Why are you always at this door?